Okay. Now about paper, which is very, very important. We are undergraduate or graduates. We are graduate students. So in addition to listen to all my lectures, one big portion that we're gonna do is for term papers. And in particular, for this course, we are going to ask you to write a so-called critique. What does that word mean? Kind of a analysis or criticism of other people's work, other people's writing. What do I want you to criticize? I want or analyze. I want you analyze, read carefully two or more. Actually, I just want two. Two research paper must be by different research groups. You say, okay, doctor, I'm working on lithium-ion battery anode. Okay, then let's say silicon anode. I want you to pick two papers on the same silicon anode, but from different group. And then to write a critique about those two paper. And those two paper have to be involved in either kinetics, how fast the process happened, or phase transformation. So one paper could be silicon phase transformation during lithium-ion battery charge discharge. Another one also on silicon phase transformation during the same process. But they are from different group. They must have some similarity. They must also have some difference. They may have similar approach. They may also have used some different approaches. I want you to carefully look, examine two papers, compare, contrast, and write critique about those two papers. Okay? So that's what the term paper is about. Ideally, you chose a topic that is directly related to your own research, whether it's high entropy ceramics, whether it's solar cell material or optoelectronic material for you, right? Or something else, lithium-ion battery, okay, or even polymers. All okay. But have to be two papers on the same topic from different group related to what? Not everything. Related to either kinetics, diffusion, interface, or phase transformation and related microstructure. Analyze and do that. Okay. And the following will have some guidance. The term paper should have the following contents. I said most, but not necessarily all. So you have to have most of these sections. What are those sections? You need to give me an introduction. A few words, one short paragraph about, okay, what is it? What is the problem? Phase transformation for silicon anode. Volume expansion during phase transformation for silicon anode. Something, right? Introduction, very short. And then it needs to have so-called the background. Another way to say it would be previous relevant literature about this topic. Very short. Okay. What has other people done before those two papers on this topic? Most likely you are not looking at the earliest paper. You are maybe looking at two papers, but those two may not be the first to look at that problem. So you tell other people, okay, what do people know before those two papers or around the time of those two papers on this topic? Okay, background or literature. And then your analysis or critique on many subjects. Significance of the problem. Why would you or other people be interested in this particular problem? Solar cell light absorber material. Why? Well, silicon is expensive or something. CIGS use something. And then we want a cheaper, material. Okay, so we study this system. Why is this problem important? And then, what is the method that the authors use to study it? What is the method? What would be the assumptions? Before he go into this problem, what has he assumed? Okay, quite often we make certain assumptions before we study. And then, if there's mathematical derivation, what's your criticism or analysis of the mathematical derivation? You may find, okay, he made some mathematical mistakes. Pinpoint that. Okay? Argument, logic. And then, of course, because many of us do experiments, try to capture in very brief term, but relevant, about, okay, what experiment design, what is the equipment setup? Okay, not in detail, but to the level that people, when they read your critique, you can roughly understand what it's about. You don't have to tell me, okay, the author is doing SEM at 15 kilovolt. That's not necessary. But he does SEM, then people know, okay, he's using SEM to do that. You don't have to tell me it's 15 kilovolt or 5 kilovolt. Make sense? That level detail may not be necessary. But okay, he's using SEM to study it. He's using X-ray for phase analysis. He's using ICP for composition instead of using EDS for composition. Make sense? You don't have to tell me, okay, how exactly he dissolved his compound to get his ICP analysis. We don't need to know that. We can refer to it, but roughly, okay, we have an idea how the research is carried out. And what about data collection? Anything special about data collection? What's the analysis or result? Very important, what's the consistency, similarity between different studies? What's the contradiction? Quite often, one people observe something, the other people observe something different. There might be contradiction. Your paper, your critique, try to capture that between those two papers. Okay? And did the authors leave any so-called unanswered questions? Has he solved all the problem? Most likely no, to be honest. Like the silicon anode for lithium-ion battery, people studied for, I don't know, 15, 20 years, and they are still having many, many, many issues. Okay? Did it also mention any so-called unanswered questions or remaining challenges? That's very important for scientific research, because that guides where you are going, where other people should be going. Okay? And your own analysis, if you have some. Okay? And the recommendations, your own recommendations about future work. And ideally, why and how? For example, okay, I want after this, you would propose using some new tool that the researcher themselves used X-ray, and you say, okay, X-ray is okay, but what about the possibility of, let's say, synchrotron? Much powerful X-ray, much faster X-ray, so that we can get more information. Something like that. They did the TEM. What about high resolution transmission electron microscope, which allow me to see the detailed structure at the interface, atomic levels in the structure? Something that you propose, you recommend for future work. Okay? Conclusions. Have you, after you criticize those two papers, what's your conclusion? Is this a worthwhile target? Have they solved the problem in a reasonable way? Or are they all bullshit? Which happens, but ideally you choose the paper, not the bullshit papers. Okay? And finally, don't forget, references. We are criticizing other people's paper, we have to have references. At least those two papers, right? At least those two.
So now we are going to talk about the format for the term paper, just a little bit. I want you to follow the format for one of the two papers that you criticized. With that, you are going to do critique on two papers. Pick one of them and follow the format exactly as it is published in the journal, whether it's one column or two columns. The font, the title, headings, subheadings, the format for the figures, the format for the reference. Try to follow the format exactly for one of the two papers that you used. And then you are going to tell me which paper you followed the format. This is just to train us to be able to follow. Because in later as graduate students, each one of you, especially PhD students, are expected to write your own paper, submit, and get them published. And one important point would be formatting. It's not as important as content, but it's still important. We want your format to look professional, to look good. Okay? And then about the length for the term paper, I want it to be single space and 3 pages maximum, excluding references. So 3 pages. Don't give me too long term paper. I want you to write a concise one, only 3 pages, single spaced, and use the space carefully. You can actually write a lot in 3 pages, and you can write well in 3 pages. Okay? Be detailed enough, at the same time be concise and clear. Concise means not too wordy. Clear means, okay, you allow other people to understand fully what you mean without too much unnecessary so-called repetitions. About the deadline, typically we will have the first draft submission in March, and for this class we'll do a draft submission, and then after you give us the first draft, we'll do a round of so-called peer review means your draft will be sent to of your peer students as well as myself for review, and I myself would act as so-called editor. So you would have in all 3 reviews, one from me as the editor slash reviewer, and another 2 reviews from your peer students. Of course, it will be so-called single blind peer review, which means you will not know who are your reviewers, who criticized your term paper first draft. But I, as the editor, would know, okay? And your reviewers would know, okay, who wrote that term paper first draft. This is part of the training for your graduate student, because especially for PhD students, most of us are expected to write papers, in particular journal papers, which will need to go through a peer review process. It will be go through the review by the editor to check, okay, if the content follows the instruction, the scope of a particular journal, if the content is of reasonable quality, and then if it meets those requirements, it will go to review by reviewers chosen by your editor. And then the reviewers will provide a feedback, an evaluation of your write-up. How good it is? Is it grammatically sound? Is it important? Does it convey a clear message? Of course, for research paper, there will be a novelty, but less of an issue for critique. But still, the logical flow, the content, the language, the argument, all these will be reviewed or criticized by fellow researcher, or we call peers. Okay, and then after we had the peer review, we're going to send the reviewer's comments as well as my own comments as the editor slash reviewer to you. And based on our feedback, the two reviewers' comments and the editor's comment, you would need to come up with a so-called final version and do a final submission. Okay, you fully digest the reviewers' comments and again read and reread the two papers that you chose and come up with a improved final version for your term paper. It may mean a significantly revised version, or it may mean a slightly revised version based on the quality of your first draft. Of course, we expect a high quality first draft. You cannot submit a crappy, a terrible first draft and hope for your reviewers to revise them for you. No, the reviewer will just find the weak points, and me as editor would also identify the major weak points. And typically, just as a typical journal, if you once submit a first version of too low quality, what would the editor do? He would just reject it at the desk without sending out for review. So you see, we want your first draft to be of very high quality as possible by you. Okay, so take time for your first draft. And then after you got the feedback from your reviewers to peer review and from editor myself, then do careful revision based on the comments. Among all the comments, you may or may not agree with all of them. So if you agree, then you change, revise it based on your best understanding. And if you disagree, it's okay, because your editor, your reviewer may not have all the knowledge, but then you politely address their concern in your so-called rebuttal file. In a response to the reviewer's comments or editor's comments. So for submission, your first submission would just be the term paper plus the two major reference. And then for your second or final submission, we need not only the term paper, the two major reference, but we also need a so-called rebuttal file or response file that addresses the reviewer's questions, comments. It may include things like, I agree with the reviewer and the editor, and I revised manuscript or the your critique in this way or that way. Or if you disagree, you can politely say, okay, we thank the reviewer for this valuable comment, but however, you don't agree for the following reason. 1, 2, 3, you listed why you don't agree and why you didn't change or revise your write-up. Okay, as long as it is justifiable. And let the editor to decide whether you or the reviewer has the better argument. And in terms of grading, missing deadline, of course, you don't get any points. And then you would get 10 points for the first draft and 10 points for the final paper. Earlier, I had to give less points for the first draft and more points for the final draft. But I realized in a typical journal, as I mentioned, it's very, very important you get the first draft right. If you get a crappy or terrible quality first draft, the manuscript would quite often be rejected at desk without even being reviewed. So to get a better chance of getting reviewed and finally get acceptance, it's very important for you to get your first draft in as good quality as possible. So that's why now I give 10 points for the first draft and 10 points for the final. Okay, and in addition, there will be 5 points for quality review provided to peer students, because each of you would also act as peer reviewers for other students' write-up. So I'm going to evaluate you for how you evaluate other students' critique our term paper, and believe it or not, most of us are pretty good at criticizing other people's write-up. However, I'm going to give you guidelines about what to do, what to evaluate for your peer students' write-up, and you have to provide a decent quality professional review to your peer students. And then there will also be 2 points for answering the reviewers or editors' comments, or so-called rebuttal files. Once a student got the comments got from the two reviewers and as well as from myself as the editor, he needs to come up, as I said, the rebuttal file or response file to address quite often point by point the comments raised by your reviewers as well as editors. And it has to be polite, it has to be clear and concise, and answer each of the concerns by the reviewer. If you agree, say, okay, I agree, and I revised the manuscript or the term paper in this way, that way. If you disagree, explain why you didn't disagree and provide your rationale, your reasoning for not changing it. Okay, so that's about the format, the guidelines, and the gradients for the term paper. Okay.